So I'm Kristin, and I have acute lymphoblastic leukemia.
And I am Benny. I am a caregiver for Kristin, who has acute lymphoblastic leukemia, or ALL.
Once I relapsed, the options were limited, and so I was able to get into a CAR T-cell immunotherapy clinical trial at Fred Hutch Seattle Cancer Care Alliance in Seattle, Washington. I was excited to be one of 29 patients that was admitted for the particular type of leukemia that I have. It was really our last hope at the time, and we are very, very excited about the research that's being done in this area, in which case they take your T cells out of your body, they re-engineer them to be fighters, and they put them back into your body, and they go and they attack the cancer that your body was not killing itself.
I'd just like to say, even though it is very, very scary to be diagnosed with cancer and to have your loved one diagnosed with cancer, it is really exciting to be part of the clinical trial, the T-cell immunotherapy. It brings such great hope to so many different people. It's so innovative. It's on the cutting edge. And I think as they develop it to cure other cancers, it'll really be at the forefront of technology and cures. And we were extremely excited to partake in this clinical trial.
So the CAR T-cell requires you first going and having, you know, physical to make sure you meet the eligibility requirements, meaning that all standard chemotherapy and other treatments have been exhausted in order to qualify. Once they deem that you're physically able to withhold it, you undergo 6 days of outpatient chemotherapy. You have a day of rest, and then you're infused on the 7th day, or the 8th day, I should say, after the day of rest, with these re-engineered cells that you would have previously donated before the chemotherapy regimen. And they have the engineered receptors in them to go and look for the markers on the type of cancer that you have and kill it. We are very excited. 1 month after I received the re-engineered CAR T cells, they did a bone marrow biopsy, and we found out that my cancer, there was no evidence of it in my body, in which case I could then use that as a stepping stone to move on to get a stem cell transplant as a hope for a gift of more time and perhaps a cure. And I think one of the things I remember Benny had mentioned is the excitement. The day of the infusion is about an hour of these re-engineered cells, much like getting a hydration bag or a blood transfusion. And so the engineered cells in a bag looks like white cells that they're putting into you. And it's over an hour, and the room was full of excitement. Benny, my mom, and I were wearing our Choose Hope t-shirts. The doctors were taking pictures, because previously it had been inpatient that they were doing it, and I was one of the first outpatient patients. And so they were coming in to see what it looked like, what the process was. So there was much difference than standard chemotherapy. And my mantra has been, once you choose hope, anything is possible. And we truly believe that immunotherapy has gotten me to where I am. And I have been in remission for 1.5 years to date. So I think the important thing to know is that CAR T cell therapy, it is available for particular types of leukemia and lymphoma. I know the ones that have been having the most success as to date have been acute lymphoblastic leukemia. I know they're looking at it, broadening that out to other types of cancers as well. And I do believe that one day it will get there. They will figure that out. And I think, you know, really talking to the doctors, they inform you very well on the side effects. But again, they're very minor in comparison to standard chemotherapy, in which case, a lot of times there's long-lasting effects that you live with.
It's hard to find some of these clinical trials, and not everybody is accepted, but you really have to be your own advocate. You really have to get out there, do your research, find the institutions that are doing the immunotherapy, talk to your doctors, talk to your networks, and you just have to be your own advocate, and you have to support each other to get there.